about to start. So I just, my name's Lawrence Bell. I'm the executive director here at the Arizona Jewish Historical Society. And when Seth Ettinger brought this idea of having the cantorial Hanukkah sing-along to us about 3 months ago as a concept, I thought this would be wonderful. So we are gathered here. Some of you have probably been here and some of you probably have not. But we are gathered here in the very first synagogue that was built here in Phoenix, Arizona. It was built in 1921. It just turned 100 years old. And it was the original home of Beth Israel, so it's appropriate for you guys. But it's also appropriate for the other congregation, because when it was built, I just want to explain. It didn't, some people always ask me, when this was built, because Beth Israel is a Reformed congregation, they said, was it Reformed? This was not Reform, it was not Orthodox, it was not conservative, it was just Jewish. So all that stuff came later. So when this was first built, it was really the only Jewish congregation. So theoretically, I guess it was the home of every congregation. So we're really thrilled to have all you guys here. I can't think of a better place to have the Hanukkah concert, and hopefully we'll keep doing these. And the other thing I wanted to tell you is it's probably maybe not the right evening to do it, but we have a really interesting, important, and very profound exhibit in the other room about the Holocaust called Stories of Survival. You're welcome to browse tonight if you like, but it doesn't necessarily always match with Hanukkah. But please do come and see it while it's up. It's going to be up for the next year. It has some new immersive technologies in it, including a hologram of a Holocaust survivor named Oscar Knobloch, and some virtual reality experiences. And it's something that you're going to want to see. And this new exhibit is also part of our larger capital campaign to create a permanent Holocaust Center here on our campus. So do please, you know, if you don't see it tonight, I understand, it's more of a festive evening, but please do come see it while it's up. It's going to be up through August of 2023. And I've probably said enough. So with that, I'm going to hand it over to Cantor Ettinger, and we'll get the show rolling. So thank you.
Thank you, Larry, and thanks to all of you for being here. I just want to acknowledge Cantor Ettinger for putting this whole program together in the first time for me. I know that it's challenging to bring this Jewish community together, and I appreciate all the effort that you put into doing just that, Seth. So thank you. So we're going to start our program this evening with a Havdalah blessing. And as you know, we like to separate Shabbat from the rest of the week, but still carry some of that sweetness with us from Shabbat into the rest of the week. So I'm going to invite the board of the Arizona Jewish Historical Society to please come up and help us with the accoutrements of Havdalah. And since this is a sing-along after all, invite all of you to join us as we sing Debbie Friedman's Havdalah. Oh. Shavua Tov, everyone.
Shavua Tov.
This is why Jewish events take so long.
Our next piece is a setting of the Shehecheyanu blessing. And the Shehecheyanu blessing thanks God for giving us life, for sustaining us, so that we can arrive at this moment. And it's used on various different occasions, but what a blessing it is for us to come together in this space. We haven't been able to sing together in a long time. Our first Phoenix Sings was in 2019, and it is wonderful in 2020 to be giving you our second Phoenix Sings Hanukkah concert. We are lifting our voices in harmony and celebration. May this evening be the beginning of a joyous Hanukkah and set the tone for a happy and harmonious New Year.
So let's join together.
want to take this time to first of all acknowledge Andrea and Jerry Lukowitz, for without whom tonight would not be possible. Thank you so much for underwriting this event and bringing us all together in song. And I want to also thank, and I'm going to thank them again and again and again, because they have put so much time and effort into this, members of our Sheer Joy and Sunshine Singer Choir. Please give them a big round of applause. I will introduce them each by name later, and lots, lots more to thank and introduce to you.
Thank you.
Happy Hanukkah, almost everybody. So I'm Cantor Seth Ettinger from Congregation Beth Israel, and it is such an honor for me to be here and bring light into our original building. And thank you all for coming out and beginning our Hanukkah festival together with us. How many of you know that some of the best Christmas songs out there are written by Jews? Well, it's true. And if I burst your bubble tonight, I'm sorry, but it's true. Well, a couple of years ago, there was a young man, Jacob Spike Krause, who said, you know what? There hasn't been some really good Hanukkah music written lately by Jews, so I'm going to do it. And that's exactly what he did. He wrote some fantastic jazz Hanukkah suites, and his album went Jewish viral. It really did, and it was absolutely fantastic. So I'm going to light up the night tonight with these words of Jacob Spike Krause. And first, I'm going to have you sing along with me, because this is a sing-along after all. The opening words, Nes Gadol Hayah Sham, a great miracle happened there. And it goes like this. Let's all try that now. Keep it going, keep it going. One more time. Thank you.
Having a good time so far? Right? We've got some excellent musicians up on this stage. Can I get a hand? Please, guys. Congregation Ortzion. And the next election that I chose, keeping in this theme of Hanukkah songs not written by Jews, this next one is actually called Hanukkah Dance, and it's written by Woody Guthrie. So Woody Guthrie actually wrote a handful of songs with Jewish themes, and a few of those specifically about Hanukkah. So Guthrie was not Jewish. However, his second wife, Marjorie Greenblatt, and their four children, including Arlo Guthrie. You can get anything you want at Alice's restaurant, except at Alice. They were all Jewish. So Guthrie became close with his mother-in-law. Yes, he became close with his mother-in-law, Aliza Greenblatt, who happened to be a Yiddish poet. And together they would share lyrics, they would share ideas, and Guthrie was exposed to Judaism through his wife, his mother-in-law, and actually began to study some Jewish texts as well. And so in the late 1940s, he wrote a few songs that were Hanukkah-related. Some of them have Jewish themes, and some of them are children's songs that he wrote for his Jewish community. This happens to be Hanukkah Dance, was recorded on in 1949. Oh, I'm looking for my pick. There it is. And he wrote it as a simple children's song. It doesn't have any particular Jewish themes, but like a children's song, it has directions on what you're supposed to do. So let's see if you can tippy-tap your toe when I tell you to. Clap your hands when I tell you to. Even better, let's see if you can jump real high when I tell you to. But I hope you enjoy this selection from Woody Guthrie. Tippy tap toe, happy Hanukkah, round you go.
I have a feeling that this next song doesn't need much of an introduction, but I'll give it a little one. So this is Debbie Friedman taking a little words from our prophet Zechariah and putting into song our Hanukkah theme of overcoming unlikely odds. But more than even the theme of this song, it's an exercise in counting and clapping. Which I think is really the point of this. So, shall we like do a quick little tutorial?
Yeah.
It's kind of like the I like to live in America kind of thing. It's like a 1 2 3 1 2 3 1 2 3 1 2 3 1 2 3 1 2 3. Can we try it?
Bye.
Another song will rise. Another song will rise. Another song.
Ready to start singing from our traditional songbook? I can't hear you. Are you ready to sing from our love songbook? It's my pleasure to invite up our Sheer Joy and Sunshine Singer Choir to join us. And we will begin, I believe this is song number 5 on your song sheets, Sevivone. It is a medley. It is a medley. You are invited to sing with us on any line you want. And it is a very, very fun one to do. Then if you want to stand and spin, you can. You can.
Oh, Hanukkah, oh, Hanukkah. is the memory that's valued so highly that we keep alive in that flame. What's the commitment to those who have died when we cry out they've not died in vain? We have come this far only believing that justice will somehow prevail. This is the burden and this is the promise, and this is why we will not fail. Don't let the light go out. It's lasted for so many years. Don't let the light go out. Let it shine through our love and our tears. Don't let the light go out. It's lasted for so many years. Shine through our love and our tears. Don't let the light go out. Don't let the light go out. Don't let the light go out. Don't let the light go out.
So as our Sheer Joy and Sunshine singers are being seated, I want to take a moment to acknowledge that we are all here tonight not only for Hanukkah, but to spread some light to those who are in need of assistance going to Jewish summer camp. And it is my pleasure to have collaborated on tonight's event with Andrea Cohen, who is in charge of the Community Camp Scholarship Fund. Obviously, you all know that associated with Congregation Beth Israel is Camp Harry and David Stein. Oh, I'm so sorry. Why did I say that? Oh, you evolved. Camp Harry and Daisy Stein. Huh. It's all the energy. It's all the energy. It's all the energy. No, Rabbi Kahn is here. He's like, oh, you evolved. I don't know. And it is our summer camp up in Prescott. But not only do we provide a camp for CBI youth, but we invite every youth from all of our congregations across Phoenix, across California, across Arizona, across this whole country, across the world to come and join at Camp Gary. Camp Harry and Daisy Stein. So anyway, I'll go ahead and end there. Our next performer, a product of Camp Harry and Daisy Stein, is our next performer, who is a student of mine, Kayla Trevino. Who is now going to be a Jewish star on Jewish Rock Radio Season 5. And she is going to be singing one of my favorites, one of our favorites, The Latke Song by Debbie Friedman. Kayla, take it away.
I can't be eaten looking as I
Every holiday has food so special. I'd like to have that same attention too. I do not want to spend life in this blender, wondering what I'm supposed to do. Matzah and haroset are for Pesach, chopped liver and challah for Shabbat. Blintzes on Shavuot are delicious, and gefilte fish no holidays without. I am a latke. It's important that I have an understanding of what it is that I'm supposed to do. You see that there are many who are homeless, with no jobs, no clothes, and no food. It's so important that we all remember that while we have most of the things we need, we must remember those who have so little. We must help them, we must be the ones to feed. I am a latke.
For those of you who don't know me, I'm Todd Herzog. I'm the cantorial soloist over at Temple Solel. And some of you may remember back in 2013, I started a music festival called the Desert Gathering Jewish Music Fest. And thank you. Some of you still remember. Some of you were sponsors. You believed in it from early on. I appreciate you. The first year that we did that festival down at Steele Indian School Park, I brought in a band from Los Angeles called Moshav. And Moshav was actually a group of musicians who started out their existence as the backing band for Shlomo Carlbach. They grew up on the same Moshav, and so that was not just a fancy name, Moshav, okay. So, anyway, there's this song that they wrote called World on Fire, and it just reminds us about how we can all get sucked into technology and things that maybe not matter as much as what's truly important, and that's paying attention to one another, and perhaps the light of Hanukkah can remind us of some of those simple truths and coming back to that. And so I hope that this song will help bring some light to the holiday. Everybody got their head in the clouds. I feel like a train on the ground. very much.
This next selection happens to be a personal favorite. It's not just me. It's Ocho Candelicas. I think a lot of you have heard of this one. Yay! It has a very interesting backstory. It was written by Flori Jagoda, who was born in Sarajevo. Sarajevo, Bosnia, had one of the oldest Sephardic Jewish communities. When the Jews were exiled from Spain and Portugal, a lot of them ended up in that area. So it's a very old community. And Flori Jagoda was born in this community. She lived there, and it wasn't until after World War II where she actually had to flee. And she and her family came to the United States. She began recording all of those songs that she had grown up with, that her nona, her grandmother, had taught her. And she actually started writing some of her own. And this one, Ocho Candelicas, is based on some of her memories of Hanukkah in the community where she grew up. And she said that it was a children's song. And it's inspired by this idea that Hanukkah was a time of matchmaking. And there was a matchmaking party every night of Hanukkah. And like little almond honey cakes were eaten as a way to assure luck. And a successful match would be made, and the hope that in the next year that there would be wedding celebrations as well. Yeah. So super fun, and I hope you enjoy it. So I'm gonna sing the lyrics, they're in Ladino, but I will cue you when it's time for you to offer, I think those words are in your, they're right there. So it's gonna be ocho candelicas, dos candelicas, so please feel free to, enjoy yourselves with that one. Okay. Hanukkah lit hasta aquí. Ocho candelas para mí. Hanukkah lit hasta aquí. Ocho candelas para mí. Oh. Uno candela.
So for those of you who have ever been to a cantorial concert, you know that no cantorial concert would be without a piece done by the great cantor of cantors, Cantor Moishe Oischer. Who, Cantor Moishoroshi, you've heard of the jazz singer. A lot of people think that that was based on Al Jolson's life, but it was actually based on Cantor Moishoroshi's life. He was the very first cantor to become that star of the screen. And a lot of the music that he composed, which were actually jazz and big band versions of some of the traditional melodies, went platinum throughout the continental United States and the world, especially when he joined forces with the Berry Sisters. You know who the Berry Sisters are, I know.
Yes.
So this song called Halavai, I always dedicate it to my wife, Sarah. She is giving me the greatest gift by taking care of our children, so I can go ahead and be here tonight. So I always dedicate this song to her. It's a song that says, Halavai, I wish I were the best person I could be for you. And the biggest present I can give you is all of my love. So I dedicate this to you, my love. As always, love you, and happy, happy Hanukkah. Here's Halavai by Cantor Moishe Oysher. So now I would like to invite up the director of the Community Camp Scholarship Fund for the Center of Jewish Philanthropy. Please welcome Andrea Cohen.
I want to thank all of you for coming here this evening to support the amazing collaboration that we have here in our community. These musicians, these cantors, we we are so blessed to have them in our community and to have them create this welcome to Hanukkah for all of us. So thank you guys so much. Thank you to the choir. I love you. Anything that has sunshine in it, I'm all for it. So I have to say, besides this hat, I wear two amazing hats when it comes to Jewish camp. Yeah, this is a good one. Yeah, it's really comfortable too. In addition to the blessing that I have to be able to administer the summer camp scholarship program, I also have been a Jewish camp director for 19 summers. And to be able to live with our kids at camp and watch them create these magical Jewish communities where we're taking care of one another, where we're just being joyfully Jewish all the time, where they don't have to worry about anti-Semitism, they don't have to worry about explaining all the fun things that they're doing. They just get to live this beautiful Jewish existence. So that's an incredible blessing. So I want to thank you guys for being here this evening. I want to thank you for helping us raise funds to send our kids to Jewish camp. I will tell you that 6 years ago, the Jewish Community Foundation was very, very happy to be able to grant out $16,000 to support Jewish camp scholarships in our community. And then we made it a real priority. And in summer 2022, we granted out $160,000 to support Jewish camp. And as impressive as that number is, for those of you who don't have kids who go to camp right now, Jewish camp is incredibly expensive. It's about $1,200, $1,300 a week to send kids to Jewish camp. So while we were able to grant out $160,000 this past year, we had requests of close to $400,000. So there's a lot of need. So I just want to say thank you to those of you who already give to our camp scholarship initiative. And if anybody else would like to, I might have a QR code out front that you can scan next to your little goodie bags that are just some thank yous from some of the camps that we partner with our camp scholarship process. And Suzanne Trevino, please come see me afterwards. You have won all that amazing Camp Daisy and Harry Stein swag and a gift certificate for camp this summer. So come see me and I'll get that to you. So thank you.
So let me introduce myself, because I haven't done that yet. My name is Cantor Noah Shashua, and I am, thank you. I am from Temple Kol Ami. So most of you don't know me because I just moved here a few months ago from Los Angeles, and before that, born and raised in Jerusalem. Now, so Hebrew is my first language, and the Hanukkah songs in Israel are a little bit different. And there is a famous Israeli Hanukkah song that the chorus is Kol echad hu or katan v'chulanu or eitan. So all of us is a light, is a small light, but is a light. And then together we are a strong, big light. So I'm going to sing a beautiful song called Be a Light. We all are lights. But it is time for us to shine and show our true light. And we do that, I do that by singing, and I know that you do too when you sing. So we're gonna sing together, Be a Light by Rabbi Neil Katz. If you wanna sing along with me, I would love that. First candle I
Thank you.
So before we end our program,
I know,
with the quintessential Hanukkah song, Ma'osur, there are many, many people that were integral to making tonight so successful, and I hope you will allow me a couple of moments just to thank everyone by name, because really this feeling, this experience was a huge effort by a lot of people. So I want to begin by thanking our event sponsors, of course, Jerry and Andrea Lukowitz, of course, as well as Congregation Beth Israel, Temple Solel, Congregation Or Zion, Temple Kol Ami, Temple Chai, Congregation Kehila, and Gesher Disability Resources. Thank you. I want to thank my colleagues for joining me on this stage. Cantorial soloist Todd Herzog, cantor Dana Rubinstein, cantor Noah Shashua, and though he could not be here tonight, I want to give a big thank you to cantor Ross Woolman from Temple Valley. I want to give a huge shout out to the Arizona Jewish Historical Society for hosting us tonight, to Mary Bell for making that happen. I want to give a big thank you to Andrea Cohen and the Center for Jewish Philanthropy Camp Scholarship Fund, and our silent auction camp swag bag sponsors, Camp Alonim, Camp Daisy and Harry Stein, Camp Ramad Ojai, Camp Hess Kramer, Gidlin Hilltop Camp, Camp Newman, JCC, Maccabee Sports Camp, for all of you tonight. If you haven't had a chance to visit our silent auction, please do so. Our media sponsor, Arizona Jewish News. Our Sufgani Yok sponsor, Mark Brenner. Big thank you to Mark. Thank you to the Coffee Bean and Tea Leaf for sponsoring our decaf coffee and hot cocoa tonight. A huge thank you to Gail Gilmartin for making sure we have the donuts and the coffee and the hot cocoa. For going out of our way to make those things happen. For the to the Phoenix Sings Joint Committee, myself. Not only myself and cantor Dan Rubenstein and cantor Ross Woolman and Larry Bell and Andrea Cohen, but also Susan Sendro and Mark Sendro. Susie Sachs, of course, and once again, Gail Gilmartin. A big, big round of applause for our Phoenix Sings performers, Kayla Trevino. The magnificent Jackie Huber on the piano. Eli Nelson, one of our Camp Stein song leaders, on the guitar. Isaac Delf on bass. Nick McGregor on percussion. And I want to give a huge, huge thank you to our Sheer Joy and Sunshine Singer Choir for adding your voices and your heart here tonight. Thank you to Linda Bandler, Sherry Cohen, Susan Guzman, Donna Harris, Barbara London, Helene Diamond Pollock, Bonnie Shuck, and Brian Weinberger. Big round of applause. And last but certainly not least, to MSU Productions for enabling us to be seen and heard tonight. Thank you.
Fearless Wrangler, cantor Seth Ettinger, who's been tremendous. Really tremendous. And it really is such a pleasure and an honor to work with you and to sing with you. Thank you.
Thank you. All right. And with that, let us sing Ma'osur Aleph. invite up our Sunshine Singer and Sheer Joy Choir to join us. I think we all know this one. If you would like to stand and put your arm around your neighbor, we invite you to do so. And we hope that you have a bright, bright, bright and joyous Hanukkah. And after our performance, we can't wait to see all of you outside at our dessert reception. Ma'od Sur. all for being here tonight.